Hi, Wackadoodle family. It is Pastor Tim. I wanted to bring you a news update this morning, and I'm going to title this one, The Calm Before the Storm. In regard to Iran, we're not surprised. We knew that they were breaching the JCPOA, what we refer to as the Iran nuke deal, particularly in regard to uranium, all the things that I reported. Well, they have publicly stated now that they have broken or breached the JCPOA. If you recall, in 2015, then President Obama really pushed and endorsed that JCPOA, which was a bad deal from the beginning. I stated that it should have never been entered into. European countries, other nations have signed on that. President Trump pulled out of that deal, not immediately. I think it took somewhere around a year, pulled out of that deal, that executive agreement, but the other nations did not. Now with everything going on, the back and forth, Iran declaring the U.S. military in the Middle East terrorist organization, the U.S. declaring the Iranian Revolutionary Guard a terrorist organization, the increased sanctions, the plummeting of the economy of Iran, all the things that we've been reporting on, we are in the calm before the storm. And Iran coming out publicly in the face of the international arena saying, we have breached. They said they were going to, and they have breached the JCPOA. Things are heating up like never before. We are seeing the alignment. The dominoes are set. The stage is set for Isaiah 17. It talks about Damascus will be utterly uninhabitable and complete ruins. I believe that's going to be at the hand of Israel. The Bible doesn't tell us that, but I believe it is based on the geopolitical and the fact that Israel is going to continue doing preemptive strikes and all the ways that Iran and her proxies, Hamas and Hezbollah, are moving so that they can come against Israel, the destruction and annihilation of Israel. Now, Iran would love to destroy America as well as the UK, where the UK seized that oil tanker that had the uranium that was heading towards Syria, even though the media, the fake news, will tell you it was sanctioned oil. It was not. I choose to believe my intel source that has always been 100% correct in those things. Back in January, I was reporting these things were going to happen. Based on intel sources, I give God all the glory. So we're in the calm before the storm. The dominoes are clearly wobbling. I'll tell you what, the convergence of signs point to the rapture soon. We'll never set a day nor hour. I just wanted to bring you that news and let you know that we are, in regard to the geopolitical, we are in what I believe is, because it's been eerily silent this weekend, eerily silent, just like the calm before the storm. Well, God bless you guys. Soon we'll be probably in an hour or so, hour and a half, we'll be going live with a message, and I believe, and it is for believers. It's a message for believers, and I believe it's right on the mark for this season that we're in. We are in the final moments of the end of days, and what we do now can have an everlasting impact. There's an opportunity for the harvest. But again, like the video earlier, he's as close to coming as one brother put it, Tyler, as close as the ocean is to the sand. God bless you guys. If you can join us or watch later, I hope that you can watch this video. Know God loves you fiercely and passionately. I want to share Jeremiah 29:11 with you. It's one of my favorite verses. I know it was the Lord speaking to the prophet Jeremiah. His heart is for his people. We are his people also. Those who have believed on Jesus, who have been saved by grace through faith. Jeremiah 29:11. For I know the plans I have for you, declares the Lord. Plans to prosper you and not to harm you. Plans to give you a hope and a future. God bless you guys. and have an awesome rest of your day.